Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Children who would like to go to Children's Chapel with Maggie, you lucky dogs. Now is when you can go.
A reading from the book of Acts. Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. You that are Israelites, listen to what I have to say. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with deeds of power, wonders, and signs that God did through him among you, as you yourselves know. This man handed over to you according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God. You crucified and killed by the hands of those outside the law. But God raised him up, having freed him from death, because it was impossible for him to be held in its power. For David says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh will live in hope. For you will not abandon my soul to Hades, or let your Holy One experience corruption. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Fellow Israelites, I may say to you confidently of our ancestor David that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Since he was a prophet, he knew that God had sworn with an oath to him that he would put one of his descendants on his throne. Foreseeing this, David spoke of the resurrection of the Messiah, saying, he was not abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh experience corruption. This Jesus God raised up, And of that, all of us are witnesses. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed for the day is 16. We will read in unison. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good above all other. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble among the people. But those who have run after the gods shall have their troubles multiplied. Their libations of blood I will not offer, nor take the names of their gods upon my lips. O Lord, you are my portion and my cup. It is you who uphold my lot. My boundaries enclose a pleasant land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel. My heart teaches me night after night. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body shall rest in hope. For you will not abandon me to the grave, nor let your Holy One see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. A reading from 1 Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now, for a little while, you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold, that though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy, for you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who is called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Well, you people are a statistical anomaly. Here in the church biz, we call this Low Sunday. It's the feast of the associate junior preacher. Anybody who ever thought about preaching to try it out, whoever has some flashy thing to offer that you don't really want to put in the rest of the year, this is the day. Here you go. Assistants and associates all over the place are dealing with doubting Thomas. And so are we. It's a crazy, huge event, and then the abiding consistency of staying with worshiping together. And I think there's some really good stuff. Low Sunday is actually one of my favorite Sundays. Is that weird? I mean, I love Easter and all the things that happen and all the people, but like, Low Sunday is like, oh, my people. People who are staying, people who will come back. It's a good thing. So Easter's this huge thing, and it really bothers me that we kind of boil it into one day. It's a lot. I mean, you go from Thursday, Jesus eating with his disciples, to the arrest, trial, crucifixion, questioning, passion gospels, crucifixion, death, burial. All this stuff happens. I mean, we read the Bible all the time, but we follow it in little pieces. In Holy Week, we go like 40 miles. It's a lot to take in. And what I believe is that the rest of Easter, which is 50 days till Pentecost, we'll still be doing Easter stuff. It's sort of like Christmas that has 12 days. Easter has 50, but nobody actually looks at that. They're moving on to Mother's Day. But at the same time, we're going to get some lessons in this whole period that are post-resurrection appearances. And even the gospeler says, there were lots more. I just told you about these. So Easter's so big. Ever been to the Grand Canyon? Ever been down in it? How are your pictures? Are they good? Do they really kind of tell you how it is? No. No. Because to experience that big thing, you have to be there personally. You have to go and stand at the edge, see the vastness of creation, the evidence of pressure and time and water, the miracle of the whole thing. I was so privileged once in my life to go all the way down the Grand Canyon, 214 miles in 9 days. And it was an amazing trip. But I can't explain it to you. I just can't. We slept outside. It sounds miserable. It was hot. The water was cold and muddy. But everything was just so beautiful and wonderful, and we just dealt with it. It was awesome. Well, I think that's what Easter's like. We can tell you about Easter. But it has to get personal. We have to take it in ourselves. We have to figure out where it fits, where we see the resurrection of Jesus. And these stories that we get after Easter are all about telling us about people and how they saw Jesus. Some of that we're jealous of because he shows up in body and Thomas gets to touch him and all that stuff. But in reality, he also shows up on the beach when they're fishing. He shows up to disciples on the road to Emmaus. He shows up in a lot of places, and 90% of the time, nobody recognizes him at first. So I kind of figure we're walking around our life with Jesus inserting himself at different points, and we just don't see it. And so what Easter is about is finding this miracle in us, taking it home, making it personal, going there ourselves. I think every preacher has really only one sermon. I'm going to tell you mine. Slow Sunday, it's just us. Don't tell anybody. I believe and preach that God is infinitely cosmic, enormous. The Grand Canyon is a drop in the bucket to the enormity of God. And we, in the sphere of time and space, are little. At the same time, this God is our creator. This God is the one who knows us. Why are we each completely and totally unique? Because we are creatures, and there's something about us that is particular, and this is also what God does, creates us and makes us for love. So my one sermon is, God is really, really big. Way bigger than you think and more involved than you want to admit. And it's personal. This God knows me and you and wants to bring you home, bring you closer. That's my sermon. It's also like my trip to the Grand Canyon, because I think if I look at the whole sphere, it's just amazing and awesome. And if I go down to the bottom of the canyon and look at one little rock worn from billions of years, that's awesome too. And every little detail in there is part of our creation meant for us to celebrate and love and appreciate and see the wonder of God. I'm not talking about just the sunset and rainbow God. I'm talking about the God that is so big, but also so personal. That's what Easter is. You people are a statistical anomaly. You're part of something so huge that it would be very simple for you not to matter. But you are part of something so small, so wonderful, so intimate, so personal as well. That's a statistical weirdo. That's an outlier. We're really important and we're not important. We're profoundly blessed, and we are profoundly broken. And what Easter says is, I can gather all this together. God says, I can gather all this together. It might take a little time for you to get it, and that's all right. So I leave you with this. In all of these lessons following, listen carefully to what they tell us about where Jesus shows up and how. Because in those stories, because there's so many and they're old, repeated for years and years, there are little breadcrumb details dropped in there that tell us a little bit about who Jesus is, just like the rest of the gospel. And after Easter, it becomes more compelling because it teaches us where to see him, how to see him, and how to incorporate him in our lives. Happy Easter. Happy traveling. We are part of something enormous, but it's personal. Amen. Let us stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son he has worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
From Form 6 of the Prayers of the People. In peace, we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work,
for our friends, neighbors, and for those who are alone,
for this community, the nation, and the world, for the just and proper use of your creation,
for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression,
for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble,
for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy,
for the peace and unity of the Church of God,
for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth,
for Michael, our presiding bishop, Mark, Gail, and Dabney, our bishops, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God in his church.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, especially Sue Raup, Rosalie Moore, O.B. Sue Thomas, Susan Cottle, Carlos Gagliano, Dean and Eileen Groby, James Anderson, Beth Colmery, Jim Jewett, Holly Fuller, Clark Stearns, Weston Herndon, Bruce Heflin, Don White, Candace Moore, Judy Klickner, Janet Crocker, Jake Kirchner, John Sandage, Karen Mott, Dora Savage, Sarah Reynolds, Davis, the Hamby family, and Chuck Pace. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom, especially Martha Craddock, Erwin Baumfalk, Fred Kinneman, and Sabrina Hamby. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins.
Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life. To the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you and forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thanks for helping out. Just act like you know exactly what you're doing. Don't ever.
We didn't have the confession.
I thought we didn't either. We do. Larry and I talked about it, but I think he was all ready. And I looked at it and didn't notice. So it's my fault. Well, stalwarts, good morning and welcome here. Back at Emmanuel Church, you always wonder who's going to come back and help clean up the party. Speaking of which, we have so many people to thank. I can't do it by name because I'll leave somebody out. You know who you are. You stepped up, you made food, you brought food. You came for the funeral yesterday, made flowers, did food for someone you may never have seen or known just because it was a church thing, and this was a bishop's wife who died, and we celebrated here, and it's a wonderful privilege to be the place where we get to do that. This person's been all over. Her husband, the bishop of West Virginia and Virginia. To have this be the place where they wanted to send her off and bury her, it's a privilege. We're part of something way beyond us, and we stepped up for church, and it was wonderful. So thank you all who made that happen, especially on the Saturday after Easter. We had to get all the plastic eggs out of the way and put the food out, so. I'm really grateful for that. The flowers today are in memory of Richard Goodling, but also we're here for the funeral yesterday for Rosemary, so good on you. Now that's Margaret Raby. I will say that. Thank you. Well done. Larry and Jennifer are away. We have Diane Kingsbury here with us as our organist. She's here often when they're not here. Jennifer texted me photos of Europe during the sermon. I told her not to do that. I'm not talking to her. She needs time away. After Easter, the parish administrator should just be gone. And thankfully, Chris Bork is helping out in the office. Chris is amazing. Yeah. So you'll hear a friendly voice if you call us or if you need anything, so please do. We did do the bulletins ahead of time simply because the technology and all that is way into Larry and Jennifer's head and not mine. But we'll put announcement inserts in to make sure we're up to date. So that's where we're going. I believe that is everything I have today. Are there any announcements that I'm forgetting about? I started off wrong. If you're new or visiting, we're glad to have you. I think we have a whole row of visitors back there, and that's great to have you. So we have a welcome table if you want to know more about us, take a swag bag, anything. We also have this amazing coffee hour. And by my calculation, each of you need to consume 1,200 calories in order for us to get this food, you know, to be good stewards of the food before it goes bad. And all the stuff that's out today, it was never put out. Okay? It was just that much in relief. So what you're eating is not leftovers, it's first timers. I promise, and I'm taking some ham biscuits with me. So. Birthdays or anniversaries? Oh, Diane has an announcement, I forgot to.
No.
Oh, it's a birthday! Aww.
His name is William Buster Gates.
Yay, Buster!
He's a golden
retriever. Diane brings us birthdays of pets and tennis players. Gives thanks for a lot of things. I love dogs, and most of us do, so. That's a wonderful thing. Great companion. Dog is just God spelled backwards. You know that, right? All right. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor on Buster as he begins another year with Diane as part of your creation made in your love. We give thanks for his presence, for his life, and we give thanks for all you have provided for us for the journey ahead. Amen. Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to God. wonderful ministry of folks who knit comfort shawls in prayer, or watching baseball, or something wonderful while they knit, and think about how this is going to help that person and ask God's blessing on them. They don't know who or where. We have another one to give thanks for today, but it's nice to say also that there's a big bin of them out there, and if you know someone who really just needs some comfort or to feel the warmth of God's love around their shoulders, period, physically, personally, take them a prayer shawl. We send them to folks who are sick and homebound, but if you know somebody who needs one, that's our ministry. It's not limited to just a few people. So the Lord be with you. Let us pray. Dear Lord, bless this prayer shawl, this comfort shawl, the person who made it, and especially the person who will receive it. May it be an outward and visible sign of your omnipotent healing power and your unconditional love. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them. He said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, whatever. What am I doing? The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. You follow me. You do these today. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. In Christ our Lord. Finally, my friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who make the journey with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and remain with you always. Amen. Second verse, and then we'll walk. Okay? Go ahead and take the cross and face us.
Face you. And then you give me the
eye. I'll move you, turn around, go.
Alleluia, alleluia. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.